You are about to enter a good news zone. Values in Action is next. Welcome to Values in Action, a show about how leaders do good in our community. In this episode, we're discussing bullying and school violence, a major problem in schools today. How can parents, teens, and teachers collaborate and put their values and leadership in action to address this problem? Our guests today are Coach Tyrone White, student Ryan Gibbons, and his parents who have put their values in action by creating a program to deal with bullying and violence. We'll be back with them in a moment. Welcome back. I'm here with my co-host Ratanjit Sande and with Ryan Gibbons and Coach Tyrone White. Coach Tyrone, this is a very inspiring program that you and the Gibbons family and others have collaborated on. What inspired you to put your values in action in this way?
Well, seeing what was going on in the city of Cleveland, which is a reflection of what was going on around the country in terms of youth-on-youth violence. And so there was a student that approached me and talked about it, and so I posed the question, what do you want to do about it? And I'm happy to say, because of the values that the families imparted in their children, that these students stepped forward to make a difference.
And Ryan, how did you feel about it when Coach approached you?
I kind of embraced it and accepted it, and I thought, well, you know, I see this kind of things happening all the time, so what are we going to do about it?
So Ryan, you are the most valuable advisor at this table because you are in the middle of it, you are young, and you see these problems firsthand. So if I put you in the White House as the president of this great nation, what changes you would bring about? How would you solve these problems? What would you do?
I probably would have to say, in one general term, which would kind of take care of a lot of it, would be dedication. Students dedicated to their school, parents dedicated to their children, teaching them the ethics, the morals needed to be kind of an outstanding citizen, a good teen leader.
But that's your wish list. How would you accomplish this?
Education, kind of keeping teens on the right track, keeping them in school, doing things that they should be doing rather than running around on the streets with, you know, automatic weapons and things like that. Keeping the parents, keeping them in work with a job, being able to support their family, keeping their students out of trouble, or their children out of trouble, and making sure that they go on the right path towards what they're supposed to be doing.
You know, let me just point out some statistics. 40 years ago, there was a survey done of teen issues in schools, and teens said that the most important influences were on them were, at that time, family, school, church, and friends. 20 years later, church was gone. Family was number four. Friends were number one. If you were to ask most teens, and I have asked teens this question today, what's the number one influence in your life? They say media. So, you know, if this is a collaboration between Coach, you, your parents, and we're trying to replicate this around the country, what chance do educators and parents have if the major influence on teens is media today?
Well, I think the media is a great thing to be influenced, but the kids need to look at it in the right perspective. And that, I think, is where the morals and your ethics will come into play. Kind of looking at a movie and not seeing some guys, you know, getting shot in the face and saying, oh, this is a good thing, but saying, you know, wow, why are people doing this?
Yes, and one of the things that Ryan and some of the others have done is they've used the media as a vehicle to communicate to young people in mass. We went to Toledo and were featured on their main television station there and did public service announcements to get legislation passed. Not only did other teens see teens stepping up, taking a role, but also our lawmakers saw teens out front. They were featured on ONN statewide, and that House Bill 19 became law to protect children that are involved in issues relating to teen dating violence and bullying.
Now, Coach, going back to education, how I see education is merely a tool. We teach them science, math, and everything else, and even the brightest of our students, they went to work for MBAs, went to work for banks and these institutions, and they are the one, educated, highly educated, sophisticated people, are the one who brought down the fort, this financial fort. So how are you going to, if education is the emphasis, what are we doing differently?
I think, and Ryan can speak to this as well, and as well as his dad, ethics. And we had a conversation earlier, and you said that, you know, as we line up the universe being very reliable, that's the missing ingredient. We have to be reliable to one another. That which we say we're going to do, we do, in terms of having regard, taking care of, protecting, and building up instead of destroying. That's where we've got to get that infused into the schools.
Coach, I want to thank you for your inspiring example and leadership. And in a moment, we're going to be back with Mike Gibbons, Ryan's father, and we're going to ask him what he's done to encourage these activities. Welcome back to Values in Action. We're here once again with Ryan Gibbons, as well as his father, Mike, and we're talking about how leaders in schools can take a stand against youth violence and bullying. Mike, in the last segment, Ryan and Coach Tyrone spoke about moral values, that Ryan felt that he had a fabric of moral values that he learned at home that then connected with what Coach Tyrone wanted him to do at school. What were those moral values you feel you and Diane instilled in him?
Well, Ryan's been raised a Roman Catholic, and I think you develop a certain set of moral values around that religion itself. But I think you know, I think one thing that's I think Ryan would also say is you know, we're kind people. We try to be kind people. We try to be helpful to others. And I think he's seen, you know, incidents or situations and circumstances throughout his life where he's seen what his parents try to do and how they try to act. And I think, you know, he's really used that as an example, hopefully. I don't want to take too much credit for my son, but hopefully he's seen things that we've done that we didn't have to do, that he's appreciated and tried to emulate that behavior. I think I've always tried to communicate to him the things I've discovered from the mistakes I've made and the things I've seen throughout my life, and try to communicate those.
Did you give him some values, or did you just give him an example of your life, which he deduced that as values?
Both, and I don't think. You know, I don't think there's a bright line what we call values necessarily, but you know, we talk a lot about politics, about what's going on in the world, about you know, incidents that we see in the news, and I guess he, unfortunately, he may not appreciate this always, but I usually provide him with some commentary on it and how I view it and how I think he should view it.
So it's kind of, you use examples as the ultimate moral message, it sounds like.
I think so. I think, you know, I don't think I wake up in the morning and say I have to communicate values to my son.
When you're dealing with your peers, do you feel that deep down everyone at St. Ignatius wants to make a difference, or do you see some individuals who are more into themselves and it just doesn't resonate with them?
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah.
How do you make a difference to the topic of bullying? What do you think we need to do?
To make kids aware of what they do. I don't think that if someone really, you know, if someone really attacks someone else and really, you know, hurts their feelings, these people don't know
that they hurt somebody.
Exactly what they did to that person. I mean, there's circumstances that they most likely don't know about, and you know, maybe that just adds on to the pressure that they're put under, things like that. And they just, there's no way of knowing exactly how much you could hurt someone by just something.
So how do we do that? Should we show them movies, or should we, what do we do?
I think what we need is just an overall better understanding of what it is to really care about your friends, care about the well-being of others. And I mean, just to bully someone is to put someone in a position that, you know, they don't want to be in. That person, it's not a, you know, a kind thing to do. You don't, it's hurtful. It really, you need to care about the person, not want to put them in that kind of situation.
So they are not connected to that emotional feeling.
Yes.
There is a disconnect.
Yes.
So if we can make them aware of those emotions which other person feels when they are being bullied, so then somebody had to think twice, I guess.
Of course.
Mike, as a parent, I'm sure that you have watched these bullying incidents on television, you know, that have been in the media recently. How do you feel someone in Ryan's position can make a difference to address this issue?
Well, I think what he's doing right now is kind of from a systematic approach of going out and communicating to these kids that probably have never really thought about the kind of things he can tell them. I think that helps.
You know, a lot of people say that bullying occurs not because of the perpetrator, but because of the bystanders, that 90% of the people are bystanders. Do you see this in your school, where people just stand by and watch negative things happen?
Of course, yeah. I mean, not only do I see it in my school, I see that, you know, everywhere else I go. I see, and not necessarily bullying, but just hurtful remarks. I mean, I don't know if you can kind of classify that as bullying, but just as little as, you know, hurtful remarks, and people kind of just standing by and being like, just kind of laughing about it, blowing it off. And that really can be hurtful to people.
So what would you as a leader do? Would you say, that's not okay? What would you do?
Yeah, you have to say, careful, calm down. Let's not say things like that. I mean, as much as they try to be funny and want to joke around and things like that, I mean, I'd be like, hey, come
on. You say it's not funny.
Yeah, not a joke.
Ryan, thanks for taking a stand. And in a moment, we're going to be back with Mike Gibbons and Coach Tyrone to talk about how adult leaders can collaborate with teen leaders to put an end to school violence and bullying.